TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India. Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Lipakshi Khurana. Here are the top stories we're tracking for you on Monday, the 7th of October. India's top court halls tree felling for New Mumbai Metro. Pakistan fares badly in terror funding report. And Sri Lankan President Sirisena abandons re-election bid. And now for all the details, India's Supreme Court on Monday halted the further axing of trees at Mumbai's RA Forest. The ambitious subway project in Western Maharashtra province has sparked protest from activists over the felling of some 2,700 trees to build a train parking shed.
India's Supreme Court issued a stay order on Monday halting the cutting of trees at RA Forest for an ambitious subway project in western Mumbai city that has sparked protests from activists opposed to the felling of some 2,700 trees to build a train parking shed. A two-judge bench of Justice Arun Mishra and Justice Ashok Bhushan ordered the Maharashtra government not to cut any more trees and to maintain the status quo. Activists and environmentalists have opposed cutting down the trees, saying it would exacerbate Mumbai's pollution level.
The Supreme Court has therefore been kind enough to say, to record the Solicitor General's statement that there will be no further cutting and that status quo will be maintained until the next hearing of the case on the 21st of October.
The court passed the directive after hearing a suo motu public interest litigation based on a letter written by a group of law students to the court against the felling of trees.
Aaj court ko state of Maharashtra ki taraf se aur metro ki taraf se ye inform kiya gaya ki jo tree cutting ka kaam tha, jo ped girane ka kaam tha, wo actual mein ho chuka hai. Isliye ulta aisa kaha gaya ki abhi further cutting of trees ki zarurat nahi hai.
Police had detained dozens of activists who had tried to stop officials from cutting the trees. The Mumbai Metro Rail Corporation Limited has started axing the trees on Friday night after the Bombay High Court rejected a bunch of petitions filed by NGOs and activists against the tree felling. The protesters have been demanding the relocation of the bus depot, which is a part of the metro project.
The International Money Laundering Watchdog Financial Action Task Force, in its latest report, has said that Pakistan has not taken sufficient measures to fully implement United Nations Security Council resolution against global terrorist Hafiz Saeed and other terrorists associated with terror groups such as Lashkar-e-Taiba and Jamaat-ud-Dawa.
International Money Laundering Watchdog Financial Action Task Force, or FATF, has said that Pakistan has failed to fully implement a United Nations Security Council resolution against UN-designated terrorist Hafiz Saeed and terrorists associated with terror groups such as Lashkar-e-Taiba and Jamaat-ud-Dawa. The FATF statement, which is part of a report published for October 2019 by its regional body, the Asia-Pacific Group, said Pakistan must identify, assess and understand its money laundering, terror financing risks, including transnational risks and risks associated with terrorist groups operating from its soil. The observations are a major blow to Pakistan, which faces the threat of being placed under the FATF's blacklist and comes a week before the agency meets in Paris to decide on Pakistan's position. Pakistan has already been placed under FATF's grey list in 2018. And was given a 15-month deadline to implement its 27-point action plan. The deadline ended in September, and the FATF is expected to have a final review of the matter during its next meeting between 13 to 18 October in Paris.
Moving on, a protest was held recently by Baloch women and children in Quetta City against enforced disappearance of a political activist by Pakistan's secret agencies. The protesters demanded release of the activist and a fair trial.
Baloch women and children carried out a protest recently in Balochistan's Quetta City against enforced disappearances by Pakistan. The protesters, led by Mama Kadir Baloch of Voice for Baloch Missing Persons, blamed Pakistan's secret agencies for abducting Rashid Hussain, a Baloch political activist and student. They claimed Rashid was arrested by UAE's secret police from Sharjah in November 2018 and handed over to Pakistan's law enforcement agencies in June this year. He has since been kept in an undisclosed location, which has added to the worries of his family about his safety and well-being.
अगर उनका कोई कसूर है और आप लोग उन पे इल्जाम आयद कर रहे हैं तो आप लोग क्यों ये बात छुपा रहे हैं कि राशिद हुसैन आप लोगों के पास है और क्यों राशिद हुसैन को आप अदालतों में क्यों नहीं पेश कर रहे हैं
राशिद हुसैन बलोच को मंजर-ए-आम पर लाना उनको फेयर ट्रायल देना ये एक कानूनी हक है और राशिद हुसैन के लिए आवाज़ उठाना उनकी फैमिली का ये कानूनी और आइनी हक है और इंसानी हकूक में ये शुमार होता है
Activists have long accused that Pakistani army and its spy agencies operate with impunity in Balochistan and used enforced disappearances and extrajudicial killings to muzzle dissenting voices in Balochistan. They blame Pakistani state institutions have totally failed to act against such inhuman crimes.
In news from Afghanistan, Afghanistan President Ashraf Ghani has fired Foreign Ministry spokesperson Sibagatullah Ahmadi after he publicly expressed support over Pakistan's hosting of the Taliban last week.
Afghan President Ashraf Ghani has fired Foreign Ministry spokesperson Sibagatullah Ahmadi after a public row between the presidential spokesperson Sadiq Siddiqui and Ahmadi. Siddiqui announced the personnel change himself in a tweet on Sunday, saying that President Ghani has appointed Mirwais Nab, the former ambassador to Turkmenistan, as the deputy minister for economy cooperation and the spokesperson of the ministry. The argument between Siddiqui and Ahmadi was over the propriety of the Taliban delegation to Pakistan. Ahmadi last week publicly supported Pakistan's hosting of the Taliban because it was in the interest of peace, while Ghani spokesperson Siddiqui condemned the meeting as inappropriate, saying that welcoming terrorists whose only agenda is war violates diplomatic norms. Meanwhile, Chief Executive Abdullah Abdullah on Sunday also reacted to Ghani's dismissal of Ahmadi, saying the spokesperson will continue in his role until after the election results have been announced. Abdullah said that dismissals and appointments at this juncture are linked with the elections and that Ahmadi's support of peace process reflects the position of the foreign ministry.
In news from Nepal, former Speaker of Nepal Parliament Krishna Bahadur Mahara has been arrested for allegedly attempting to rape a woman staff in a secretariat. Police took Mahara into custody on Sunday after the accuser filed a formal complaint against him on Friday.
Nepal police has arrested former Parliament Speaker Krishna Bahadur Mahara after a female staff at the secretariat accused him of rape. Police took Mahara into custody on Sunday after court ordered to investigate the rape complaint filed formally by the accuser on Friday. Mahara stepped down from his post as the Speaker on October 1st after mounted pressure from his Nepal Communist Party as well as the public. The former Parliament Speaker had refuted the allegations and said the accuser was trying to seek revenge for not helping her become a permanent employee at the secretariat. He said he resigned only to facilitate a fear prop into the allegations, raising serious questions about his character. The National Human Rights Commission has also formed a three-member panel to monitor investigations into the alleged rape charge against Mahara.
Moving on to news from Sri Lanka, candidates on Monday registered for the upcoming presidential polls in November in capital Colombo. A total of 41 candidates, the largest in the history of Sri Lanka, have placed deposits to run for the polls. However, Sri Lankan President Maithripala Sirisena has decided not to stand for re-election.
Sri Lankan President Maithripala Sirisena has decided not to stand for re-election in November presidential polls, which means he will leave office the day after the election, cutting short his five-year term by 52 days. Sirisena's name was not on the list of 41 candidates who paid deposits by Sunday's noon deadline to contest the November 16 presidential polls. Candidates on Monday registered for the upcoming polls in capital Colombo. Notable candidates include former Defence Chief Gotabaya Rajapaksa of the main opposition party, the Sri Lanka People's Front, and Sajid Premadasa of the ruling United National Front.
We are extremely confident that the vast majority of Sri Lankans of all ethnic, religious backgrounds, irrespective of caste, creed, will support this monumental, path-breaking program which will make our country prosperous and a country where prosperity is enjoyed by everyone.
The election is likely to be dominated by national security issues after a wave of suicide bombings claimed by Islamic State. More than 250 people were killed in April bombings, denting the island's critical tourism industry.
Devotees across India thronged temples on Monday on the occasion of Navami, the ninth day of Navratri festival, to seek blessings of the Hindu goddess Durga. During the nine-day festival of Navratri, devotees perform special prayers and also observe fast.
Hindu devotees across India on Monday thronged temples to offer prayers to Hindu goddess Durga on the occasion of Navami, the last day of the nine-day Navratri festival. Jhandewalan Temple in the country's capital New Delhi was decked up as people gathered to attend special aarti, a Hindu religious ritual of worship on the occasion. Navratri holds immense importance in Hinduism. It is believed that during the festival, goddess Durga descends on earth to destroy the demons and bless her devotees with happiness and prosperity.
Navratri mein maa ke pratham swaroop se lekar aur nave swaroop siddhidatri tak bhakton ne jis bhakti bhav se maa ko bhajan kiya hai, maa ko manaya hai, maa ki seva ki hai. Us sare ka nichod maa siddhidatri, uska sara phal सभी सिद्धियों को देने वाली, सभी सिद्धियों को धारण करने वाली माँ सिद्धिदात्री अपने भक्तों को स्व-स्व मनोकामना जिस जिसकी जैसी जैसी मनोकामना रही होगी उसने माता के सामने प्रकट किया होगा उस तरह की कामनाएं माँ आज के दिन अपने भक्तों की पूरी करती हैं.
Meanwhile, devotees in spiritual city of Varanasi performed special havan wherein an oblation or any religious offering is made into fire. The ritual is performed on the auspicious occasion to purify the atmosphere, casting a healing effect on the mind and the body. Each day of the 9 days during Navratri has special implications and rituals are performed accordingly.
यार जी नवरात्रि का आखिरी दिन है और ये दुर्गा जी के नौ दुर्गे का आखिरी दिन होता है इसका बहुत ही महत्व है आज के दिन जो लोग नौ दिन का पूरा देवी की आराधना करते हैं आज ही के दिन व्रत को तोड़ के और देवी माँ के उपासना करके इस व्रत को पूरा करते हैं.
During Navratri, Hindus also fast to please goddess Durga. Some spurn meat, onions and garlic in their diets. Devotees believe that by controlling physical needs like hunger, a person can gain spirituality and that fasting helps in creating harmony between the body and soul.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude, the top stories once again. India's top court halls tree felling for New Mumbai Metro. Pakistan fares badly in terror funding report. And Sri Lankan President Sirisena abandons re-election bid. Now our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/SAsianewsline and follow us on Twitter at SAsianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.